Are you feeling out of sync, maybe out of rhythm, maybe a little de-energized, demotivated, or unmotivated, right? Are you feeling this way? You see, I know that many times after a holiday, after a vacation, sometimes in the middle of the year, if we are behind in our goals, we can be uninspired, unmotivated, and we can get out of momentum. How are you doing your business? Are you in momentum or are you out of momentum? Do you know what momentum is? You see, we have to know because knowledge is power. Knowledge, when you have the knowledge and awareness, you can shift, you can make the tweaks, the changes that's gonna help you to grow and improve. So what is momentum? Momentum is activities. Momentum is progress. Momentum is little wins, is breakthrough. Momentum is movement. Momentum is action. When we are in momentum, everything is great, isn't it? You feel great. It's hard to feel down or feel like in a slump if you have a lot of momentum, if you have a lot of appointments, if you have a lot of signatures, if you are selling a lot of things, you know, selling your products, your ideas, your service. Momentum brings so much joy, brings energy, brings money, brings lots of things. Momentum will cure 95 to 98% of your issues, of your challenges, of your problems at work, in business. So, are you in momentum? It's very normal if you are behind your goals or if you're coming from a vacation or from a long holiday to feel out of momentum because you got out of your routine, you got out of your rhythm, and many times you stop the actions that builds momentum and then you feel funny, you feel deflated. And many times if you don't go right back into your routine, if you don't go right back into your morning routine, including the actions that brings the revenues, into the actions that brings your money, the actions that take you to your goals, if you don't take the actions that moves the needle, right away, you start feeling guilty, you start feeling bad because you know you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing, and then the guilt and other feelings makes you feel horrible, deflated, it drains your energy, and then we go in our head. The moment we go in our head, my dear friends, we become emotional, less objective. We become ineffective, inefficient, because when we are emotional, we lose clarity, we lose focus, and we become very reactive, very reactive. So what kills momentum? Momentum is killed by many, many reasons. But number one is lack of action. Lack of action. People stop doing what got them there. They stop taking the action that builds the momentum, that builds activity, that brings appointments, signatures, success, wins, activities, and movement, right? So don't let your momentum die. If you are in momentum right now, the number one cure, let me give you the cure. It cures it all. It cures lump, funkiness. It will cure your low energy. It will put you right back up. Massive action. Massive action. So, this is Coach V here giving you some great tips, advice, strategy to get you back in momentum, to get you back in action so you can move ahead, move the needle, and you don't go in your head and get derailed. So let's go quickly here. Some of the reasons why you are out of momentum. Okay, number one, you stop doing what got you there. You stop doing what get momentum here. You're not taking actions on the activities that brings appointments, that brings signatures if you are in sales, in any business, right? Because any business we are selling. So whatever it is, if you are not having appointments, if you're not talking to people and creating new business and building the relationship for business to come, you will not have results, you will not have movement. Okay, another thing that stops momentum is sometimes when you get overwhelmed. If you are too busy, you can become overwhelmed and you might have what we call, you know, fear of success. Oh, maybe I shouldn't do so much right now because I'm already so busy. I have so much already in my pipeline. What happens if I get another appointment? What happens if I get more business? Then I can't service the business. Then I don't have enough staff. I don't have enough people. I don't have enough systems. And then again, you can sabotage yourself, boycott yourself, and go down very fast because you don't want to have more business because you start having some self-negative self-talk, some negative self-talk, and you take yourself out of the game. Another thing that kills momentum that you have to be very careful, you know what it is? Ego. Ego. When you get to a point, I got this, I know this, I don't need any more help, I don't need to make those calls, or I don't need to learn this, I got it down. Ego is a huge way of killing momentum, of stopping you down. I don't need to learn anymore, I don't need my coach anymore. And then you stop communicating, you stop learning, you stop improving, because you believe you have it all, you know it all. Ego kills momentum immensely, so be very careful. Another kind of self-talk you might have that kills momentum is when you start self-doubting yourself. You know, self-doubt's a really big one. Oh, you know what? This was only a fluke. I don't think I can do it again. This is not happening to me. You know, I was lucky. So be very careful with your communication to yourself, with your way of thinking. Be very aware of your paradigm so you don't bring some old self-limiting beliefs to your life, to your business, and that way you don't stop doing what got you there. So emotions, egos, lack of action, right? Doubts, fear, and many, many times it's just because you have not decided to go right back into your morning routine after your holiday. So you're still out of sync, out of rhythm. You have not decided yet just to go ahead and take massive action. So my medication for you today, my remedy for you today, my assignment for you today, for you can go right back into high momentum. So you can feed Mr. Mo. I like to call Mr. Momentum Mr. Mo because he's a sexy beast. He's an amazing beast. When momentum is in the house, you have business, baby. You got appointments, you got signatures, you got things happening, you got deals closing, because momentum comes in direct proportion of your consistent actions with high intensity. Let me say that again. Momentum comes in direct proportion of your consistent action and high or level of intensity. So more consistency, more intensity, higher momentum. No consistency, no intensity, very little momentum or no momentum. So if you are in a funk right now, low energy, feeling de-energized, go inspire yourself, go take a look at your great goals, your dreams, then go take some action. Massive action, darlings, massive action, warriors. Put your plan right now. Create a massive action, a plan of attack this week for an hour and a half. I'm gonna talk to 20 people. I'm gonna set 5 appointments. A day, excuse me, the conversations a day, the 5 appointments for the week. So let me say it again. This week, I'm going to talk to 20 people a day, 15 in the morning, 5 in the afternoon, and I'm going to set 5 appointments. I guarantee you, if you do that for 30 days and then do another 30 days and do another 30 days, you're going to create such a fantastic momentum, such a wonderful momentum. You're going to be excited, energized, inspired, engaged, super, super passionate, and you're going to have appointments, and you're going to have the best fall and the best winter. Because when you work smart, when you work hard and you are intentional on purpose and you do what it takes to create momentum, you will have beautiful business, you will have appointments, signatures, and lots of sales. So go do your job, stay strong, keep inspiring, keep learning. Talk to you later. And by the way, I am going to make sure that from now on you're going to have some great videos weekly on YouTube. So share this video with anyone that might be needing some momentum, some energy, some passion, and make sure that you give me a comment. Tell me what you like to hear more. What should I help you with? What questions you have for me? Give me a comment, give me your information, and I'll bring to you the best that I can. So share this video, give me some love, give me some comments here, and let me know what else you want to hear. Talk to you soon. Bye.